Welcome to the What's New presentation for MDA 8.7. My name is Matthias Gekeler. At ETAS, I'm the product manager for MDA. In the present video, I'm going to demonstrate the new features and improvements listed here. In the description below the video, you can find jump marks to access a topic directly. First, I'd like to present the possibility to provide configuration contents for older MDA versions. A configuration is the frame for displaying signals from measurement files, for example in an oscilloscope. Moreover, it can include calculated signals which are derived from signals from the measurement files. Besides the graphical instruments like oscilloscope and scatterplot, MDA offers different table-based instruments as well. Still, there exists the limitation that a configuration can be loaded only when it was saved with the same or an older MDA version. To enable, at least partially, that a configuration can be reused in an older MDA version, the export functionality was enhanced. Before the actual export is done, the configuration must be saved. Afterwards, as newly supported export file format, XDA can be chosen. The export into the XDA format is limited to oscilloscopes, scatterplots and tables only. This is because older MDA versions can import only these instruments. To show the import, I'm using the old MDA version 8.3.4. For all subsequent versions of MDA 8, the procedure and behavior is the same. After the XDA file was selected for the import, its contents get displayed in the old MDA version. But there are some specifics which are mainly caused by limitations of the XDA format. Obviously, for each imported instrument, an own layer is created. This is done since the XDA format does not support layer information. The layers created by MDA get the instrument's name. Moreover, the XDA format does not include a potential file time offset. And calculated signals are already excluded by the exporting MDA version, simply because older MDA versions cannot import calculated signals which were defined in another MDA 8 version. The current behavior and its limitations should be seen as an intermediate workaround to enable at least a partial exchange with older MDA 8 versions. Currently, we are working on a solution for a comprehensive exchange of configurations between different MDA 8 versions. Next, I will present a new instrument for displaying battery cell voltages. There exists already an instrument for a graphical representation of the imbalance values for all battery cells. In this imbalance graph, each bar stands for the deviation of each cell voltage relative to the mean of all cell voltages. MDA 8.7 offers the new voltage graph instrument to display the absolute cell voltages. You can add the desired signals as usual to the instrument. For example, via drag and drop from the configuration manager while pressing the control key. The signals in the instrument are sorted alphabetically by the signal names. As for the other battery instruments, the display data is for exactly one point in time. Synchronization with other instruments is supported. This means you can navigate with a cursor to a specific point in time in the oscilloscope. Accordingly, the other instruments display the data for the same point in time. The new instrument offers another property. It is possible to define an upper and a lower limit for the voltage values. These limits are displayed as horizontal lines. If the voltage values are outside the range between the higher and the lower limit, the bar gets a red or a blue color. In the following section, I'd like to demonstrate some improvements for the variable selection. To shrink the number of signals in the variable explorer quickly to a better manageable amount, the filter categories are offered. There are now two new categories, namely for the raster and for the ECU information. especially for the category raster, the search functionality is helpful. For example, in case of a bus monitoring, there might be many different raster entries. These can be filtered quickly by means of a search string. Using the Select All option avoids to click multiple times to combine the different entries. The option Invert Selection allows to activate all other entries except the formally selected ones. And when the filter category raster is combined with another filter category, a short list of signals remains after a few clicks. Also, for adding signals to instruments, an enhancement was done. For a better illustration, I show the current setup of the configuration in the Configuration Manager. There exist two layers with different types of instruments and just a minimal number of signals in each instrument. After one or more signals were selected in the Variable Explorer, a new context menu is offered. It opens a dialog for the selection of the desired target instruments. The checkboxes indicate to which instruments the signals will be added. The new signals are inserted at the default position. This means in the top strip of an oscilloscope. In a scatter plot, new strips are created at the bottom. In table instruments, new columns are added at the right. And the statistics instrument gets new rows at the bottom. The dialog to replace signals was reworked. For a clear identification of a signal, the pure signal name is not sufficient. This is obvious when thinking about comparing signals from different measure files. In fact, the ASM standard for MDF4 files defines that besides the signal name, further meta information is required. This includes ECU, device, and some raster information. MDA is using the complete set of meta information in the background. For a better usability, most of these details are hidden in the UI. If needed, you can activate the respective columns for ECU and device in the Variable Explorer and in the signal list of the oscilloscope. Since the meta information is essential when a signal replacement shall be done, the corresponding dialog was reworked and extended. Now you can easily see the ECU and device information for all potential replacement candidates. Moreover, you can clearly identify by the information in the header of the dialog which signal will be replaced. This helps to prevent mixing up the signals. Let's reopen the dialog under the same starting conditions. To understand better the impact of the replace operation, the second option of the dialog was slightly modified. As before, you can decide that the replacement shall be limited to the currently active instrument. Alternatively, you can extend the option to the complete configuration, including calculated signals. In my example, you can see by the changed signal curve that the calculated signal was included. And a third enhancement is available. So far, the replacement was limited to a specific signal ECU device combination. Now the dialog allows to extend the replacement to all signals which have the same signal name. So the ECU and device information is ignored. This is helpful if your measurement files contain signals which can be differentiated already by the pure signal name. But still, over the time, it can happen that signals get into no match state. Then the new option allows to unify the signals again. Keep in mind to apply the new option carefully. Signals which were handled by MDA as being different will be combined and will then represent identical signals. Also, the calculations were enhanced. Again, the function library includes some new functions. From these, I'd like to demonstrate the calculations of rolling values. For my example, I use a signal which shows some variance. For the calculation, I select the new rolling function. As usual, I assign the input signal by drag and drop. Then I can define the time range for the rolling calculation. As outputs, minimum, maximum, average, integral, and sum will be calculated. These are listed in the variable explorer under the name defined by me for the function instance. In the oscilloscope, it is visible that the calculation is done in a rolling manner for the time range defined in the function instance. The time range can be modified afterwards. When saving the changed time range, the recalculation is triggered. Let's have a look into the new feature of backup configurations. Whenever you conduct a change in a configuration, an asterisk will indicate that the configuration has unsaved changes. Then MDA 8.7 will create a temporary backup configuration additionally to the original configuration. The backup is done periodically every 3 minutes and saves the current state of the configuration. In my example, it is visible in Windows Explorer that this was already done for all currently used configurations. Besides creating such backup configurations, it is also important to clean up the additional files, then these are no longer needed. Therefore, when a configuration is saved, the backup file will be deleted. Also, when a configuration is closed in a controlled manner, the backup file is removed. But if MDA is closed uncontrolled, the backup files remain. Such a situation might happen by an unexpected program break-off, like an exception, or when you kill MDA via the task manager. At the next start, MDA detects that and which backup files exist. Then you can decide how to continue. You can choose between the state when you have saved the configuration the last time. This is meant by the entry original. Alternatively, you can continue with the backup configuration, or you don't want to open any of both. Accordingly, either the backup variant is opened as a new configuration, or the backup file is deleted. The new configuration created from the backup is completely independent from the original configuration. Both can be opened and used in parallel. We hope that you will not need this new feature. Nevertheless, in case an exception happens, it will help to restore at least a part of the unsaved changes. To avoid confusion when you continue with the backup configuration, it is recommended to save it under a new name. And then delete the former backup file in Windows Explorer. The topic of the present section is about the interoperability between MDA and INCA. In the INCA experiment environment, different types of variables can be visualized and recorded. INCA supports calibratables like values, curves, and maps, as well as measurements. When calibratables are recorded, there are two variants. One is to record just the calibration activities, so every change of the calibratable. And secondly, for each calibratable, a periodic measurement can be derived. We call these measurecals. After triggering MDA from the INCA experiment, any signal in the measurement file is listed in the variable explorer. It can happen that a recording in INCA shall be redone, but only the measurement file is available. Then the formally recorded signal names can be exported from MDA into a label file. To do so, the dialog to generate a measure file offers a list of all supported file formats. Besides the already known lab file format version 1.3, there is now also a new variant named version 1.3 INCA dialect. By the way, there are some smaller improvements for the export dialog. Now it provides two separate fields, one for the file path and one for the file name. The recently used file names can be selected from a drop-down menu. And finally, the file extension is set automatically for the selected file format. Both lab file variants can be used in INCA as filter in the variable selection dialog. For both versions 1.3, INCA is using the device information in the lab file as additional filter in combination with the signal name. Then, with the ordinary lab file version 1.3, all measurements are found. However, when the variant INCA dialect is used, not just real measurements, but also calibratables, and moreover measurements derived from calibratables are found. This facilitates to recreate the same experiment environment as it was when the former recording was done. The following section is about the behavior when migrating to a new MDA version. MDA and INCA are released on a quarterly basis. Most of the new versions are so-called service packs. These can be identified by the third digit of the version number. When the seventh digit is changed, like from MDA 8.6 to 8.7, this is called to be a new minor version. For each minor version, MDA is using a different folder for user-specific files. At the moment, this applies for INI files, for ASCII-based measurement files, as well as for FMU files to define your own calculation functions. When the new minor version is installed, the mentioned folders contain just the files delivered by ETAS. So far, these are an example and a description file for the ASCII-based measurement files. At the very first start of any new MDA installation, it is checked whether there exists a former MDA version. If so, the user-specific settings are copied and reused. This is why you can immediately see the last used configurations even in the new MDA version. Additionally, when a new minor version is started for the first time, the folders under program data are checked. If they are INI or FMU files from a former MDA minor version, these are copied into the folder for the new minor version. This allows to read and write the already defined ASCII formats without further activities, and also using the existing FMU files is directly supported. Please keep in mind, the migration of the files happens only once, namely at the very first start of the new MDA minor version, and just the folder of the highest available former MDA minor version will be considered. And one further feature can be mentioned. For the export of ASCII-based file formats, two new options were introduced. These enable to include for each signal the information about its origin. You can choose between the source file name or the source file path and name. This allows to differentiate in the new measurement file signals with the same signal name, but from different measurement files. Finally, you can see here the overview of all changes done in MDA 8.7. For more details, please have a look into the What's New slide set. You can find it, as well as further information materials, both directly in MDA 8 as well as on the ETAS homepage. Thank you for your attention and for your interest in MDA 8.